Let's get some practice subtracting mixed numbers. So let's say that I had 2 5/8 minus 1 2/8. Minus 1 2/8. What is this going to be? And I encourage you to pause the video and try to work it out. Well, we could rewrite this. We could write the numbers on top of each other. We could say this is 2, do that magenta color. Say this is 2 5/8. Actually, let me write them a little bit further spaced apart. 2 5/8 minus 1 2/8. And then we can subtract. And we could say, okay, look, in this column right over here, we are subtracting eighths. We have 5/8, and we're gonna subtract 2/8. If I have 5 of something and I subtract 2 of them, I'm gonna have 3 of that something. And in this case, we're talking about eighths. So 5/8 minus 2/8 is going to be 3/8. And then you have 2 1s minus 1 1, or 2 minus 1 is going to be 1. So this is going to be equal to 1 3/8. Now let's do something more interesting. Let's say that we had 3, I'm just gonna make up a number here, 3 2/5, 3 2/5 minus 2 3/5. And like always, pause the video and try to work it out. Well, let's try to work it out this exact same way. So I'm gonna rewrite it as 3, let me do it in that same magenta color, trouble changing colors. We have 3 2/5 minus 2 3/5. 2 3/5. And when you first try to do it, over here you had 5/8 minus 2/8. That was easy to figure out. That's 3/8. But then over here you have 2/5 minus 3/5. Well, that's hard. 3/5 is larger than 2/5. So what can you do here? Well, one option is to regroup. Let's take 1 from, I guess you could say, the ones place here. So let's take 1 from this, and then that's going to turn into 2. And then 1 is the same thing as 5/5. So 2 5/5 is equal to 7/5. So another way of thinking about it, I'll do it over here. We could write the same, 3 2/5 is the same thing as 2 7/5. 2 7/5. These two things are equivalent. Why? Well, I took 1 away from here to get to 2, and then I added that 1 over here. 1 is the same thing as 5/5. 2 5/5 is 7/5. So now if we consider this thing to be 2 7/5, we're ready to subtract. If you say 7/5 minus 3/5, that's going to be 4/5. And then you have 2 - 2 is 0 1s. So you're just going to be left with 4/5. So this is just going to be 4/5. Let's do that again. Let's do one where we have to regroup again. And I'll just write it out in a column up down to begin with. Let's say that we have 7 1/6 minus 4 5/6. Minus 4 5/6. What is this going to be equal to? Well, when we try to subtract 5/6 from 1/6, well, that's hard. 5/6 is larger than 1/6. But we can regroup. We could take 1 from here, so the 7 becomes a 6. And then we take that 1, which is the same thing as 6/6, and add it to 1/6. So 1/6 plus 6/6 is going to be 7/6. Is going to be 7/6. Let me be clear what I did. I took 1 from the 7 and it became 6, and 1 is equal to 6/6. And so I added 6/6 to that 1/6 and I got 7/6. So I took the 1 from here and I added it over here, and the whole purpose is now 7/6 is greater than 5/6. So 7/6 minus 5/6 is, I'm doing that orange color, is 2/6. And 6 - 4 is 2. So it's gonna be 2 2/6. Or if we wanted to rewrite 2/6, let's see, they're both divisible by 2. This is the same thing as 2 1/3 is equivalent to 2/6. So you could also write it like that.